she doesn't want no so-so. Had a man last year, life goes on. Haven't let a thing loose, girl, it's so long. You been inside, how you like to lay low. I've been people, what you bringing to the table. Working hard, girl, everything paid for. First, last, phone bill, car, no cable. Put your phone out, gotta hit the payable. Put your phone out, snapping like you Fabo. Ain't showing no, but it's alright. Ain't showing no, but it's alright. Growing up, I was in and out of dance schools and in and out of competitions and being trained in different spaces and all of that. I think at the time as a teenager and going into your early 20s, you don't really understand what you're going to do with the dance, with what you're learning. You don't understand where it's going. So your kind of role models on this are more like the teachers. So you're like, okay, so from here, I'm going to be a dance teacher or something. And for me, I just wanted to dance in any space, in every opportunity that there was. So I would do whatever needed to be done to dance. So whether it be competitions or shows that was put on or anything like that. So for me, it was also coming out of my shell again, and I love dance. So dance is just that free expression thing. So for me, at that time, exploring other dances and getting into different concepts, different gigs and different events and things, I started learning that that dance has somehow, for me, become really closed off, because when I tried to enter through here, then I got knocked out or bumped out or spat out, or it's just like, no, you're not welcome, no, you can't do this, no, you can't. Then I found other ways of trying to enter through and sort of getting those entries back into it again, and then it's sort of as if I found a back door and then the same people who spat me out, kicked me out, pushed me out the first time would be there and be like, how'd you get in? Shit just got worse, things are getting intense now. I hear you talking about me a lot, or you speak French now. Giving me the sign, so I gotta take a hit now. I hit you up like, do you wanna hang right now? On the east side, you know what you're So you got to look at what exists, what is already out there. So that's where also the step back came into perspective for me. So I took a step back and I could see what exists in dance, what exists in me, what exists in what I have done in my life. So how does everything that I've done link up together in what, how is this forming me? Because there was a stage when I felt like, after going into the dance industry and understanding all that I've explained already, and then taking a step back and getting a perspective on myself, I felt like I was just doing too much. Like I wanted to do everything and anything, and I just did this in dance, and then I was doing a talk, and then I was doing a mentoring, and then I was like, why am I doing so many different things that doesn't make sense? everything started like connecting for me until it came to this culmination of I am now a dancer. I'm also doing my master's in dance psychology, in psychology for now. And I'm also a mentor, and I also work in a mentoring program. And I'm also a counselor. So all of those things are just linked up, and I can name many things that I am. But if people actually ask me, what is my title? I can't give you a title. So that's okay, because I'm Simone. What can I do? What am I doing?